Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about layer 2 securities, like layer 2 security features. We need to discuss about it. So in layer 2 security features, we know that we have so many things, like we can put security over network, we can go for DHCP snooping if any DHCP spoofing attack is there. We can go for DAI, dynamic ARP inspection in this. Okay. So what is DHCP snooping actually? DHCP snooping is a security features that acts like a firewall. Firewall is a security device. It is act like a firewall between untrusted host and trusted DHCP servers. Okay. The feature performs the activities like it validates DHCP messages, receives from untrusted sources and filter out invalid messages. Okay, so this is also used for some features. And besides this, dynamic ARP inspection is a security features that validates ARP, address resolution protocol. Address resolution protocol is basically used for IP to MAC address, like you can resolving process. Like DAI, dynamic ARP inspection, allow a network administrator to intercept, log and discard the ARP packets with invalid MAC address to IP address binding. So this capability protects the network from certain man-in-middle attack. Okay, so it is used with the process of man-in-middle attack. And after that, port security is the feature in which you can provide security to specific LAN user also. Okay, so for this, okay, let's start with some practical on Cisco packet tracer. We'll do the practical on Cisco packet tracer here. So in Cisco packet tracer, we can go for, where is my Cisco packet tracer? Okay, we have to set up here one switch and PCs 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I'm providing IP address to PCs 20.0.0.1, 20.0.0.2, and 20.0.0.3. Now they are pinging with each other, and when they will ping with each other, they will provide their MAC address to switch. Now you can check. Show MAC address table. So dynamically MAC address of every PC is like installed in MAC table of switch. So if any other PC is using there, then their MAC address comes with this. Now what port security will do? Now port security will like assigned static MAC instead of dynamic. So if, for example, this is XYZ PC, so I want to assign its MAC address permanently to this PC. So this cable can be used by this XYZ PC only. No other user from another network or with the same network is not able to access from that specific port. So we have three types of port security violations. Like we can use protect, we can use restrict, and we can go for shutdown. But most of the time in company, we use only protect command, and 80% we are using protect, then mostly the rest part we go for restrict configuration. We don't use shutdown because when we use violation shutdown in port security, then the port is totally shut down. So what I will do, I will put protect violation on XYZ, restrict on PC1, and shutdown on PC number 2. So let's start with the configuration. So I have to go on this. What I will do, I will do the command. Interface, first F0 by 1. F01 switch port mode access, switch port port security, switch port port security. Now I have to mention how many maximum MAC address I want to implement. So maximum MAC address should be one only, but you can put 1 to 132 MAC address. So switch port port security MAC address I have to say here. Sorry, MAC address I have to set here. Either I can go with manual MAC address or I can use a sticky command. Sticky command is used for dynamically, it will check the MAC address and installed in MAC table statically. And at last, switch port port security violation protect. So in this I have used protect violation. So with the help of protect violation, I will copy this and I will put it on notepad for you. This is my command that I have used. So when you are going to implement, like instead of protect, you are going to implement on F0/2, what you can do? You can do on F0/2, commands are same, but restrict should be there the violation. Rest all things should be same. Okay, so I'm putting this thing. And on next time on F0/3, I want to put shutdown. So within this video, I can show you to all the violation that can be used in security. So at F0/3, I have put shutdown. Rest all other commands are same. Okay. So show port security. When you will go for port security, now you can check here. This one. F0/1 is configured with protect. F0/2 is configured with restrict. F0/3 is configured with shutdown. Like all three PCs are configured. Now if you will ping XYZ to PC1, then successful. PC1 to PC successful, but show MAC address table provides you static entry. So after provide, they are providing static entry to you. Now if anybody use protected PC with another PC, like this is also 20.0.0.4, it is not able to ping. But if this cable is used by XYZ, then XYZ can ping. Now what is the difference between protect and restrict? If you use protect, then there is no problem. But if you will use restrict here, okay, like restrict cables you are using, then you are not able to ping to this. Okay, there is no pinging, there is no pinging. But when you will check show port security, you can check security violations can be counted. So security violations can be counted here. But if you use this cable into again this PC1, then they are able to ping. But what is the drawback of shutdown command? Shutdown commands, then you can use shutdown. If you are pinging with any PC, your port will be shut down. So that's why I was saying that protect violation was best and restrict is also best. You can check the security violations in this, but shutdown is not good because in shutdown now I have to put error disable recovery mode, and after that I have to manually change all the configuration on our switch. So this is all about layer 2 security. Thank you.